How much money is enough money? And have you ever heard someone say this, right? This statement, which is rich people are greedy. No matter how much money they do end up getting, they're never happy, right? And it's never going to be enough. Now, I've noticed something with people that are having financial problems, usually just poor people, right? But I'm going to use that financial problems as an excuse for that term, right? I notice people that have financial problems are always thinking about a fixed sum of money that if they had that money, all their problems would disappear. So for example, say you're poor, say you're not financially inclined, say you're not financially free, and if you're not financially free, you're poor. I'm a poor person until I get to financial freedom, which is I don't have to work unless I want to. And if you're not at that stage, you're poor too, right? So this is my thing, right? A lot of people that are in the working class, in the middle class, in the lower class, they constantly think about, for example, the lottery, right? Wow, if I win the lottery, it's over. I don't ever have to work again. I don't have to do anything. So what are you actually going to do? Is that a true statement? If you were to win the lottery, would you not work? Would you not do anything? Like, honestly, a lot of people say, look, I would just go around the world. I would experience. I would buy this. I would buy that. And I would buy this and that. And there's actually a study that proves that a lot of people that win the lottery, within like 1 to 5 years, they go right back to the place that they were because that's the amount of money they were actually comfortable with handling. So it doesn't matter the amount of money you have. It matters the amount of incline that you have to actually manage that money. So when people say how much money is enough money, it all matters into what you want from life. For example, let's use one of my friends, right? One of my friends makes around $130,000 a year. Right, which is a lot of money. That's around $6,000 to $8,000 a month, something like that. So say, for example, he's making this amount of money and now he wants to live in the future, right? He wants to be financially free in the future. So he tells me, Tommy, I want to be financially free in the future. And I ask him, how much money would be enough money for you to quit the job that you have right now and do something that you actually love doing, right? And he tells me, well, maybe like around $70,000. And I say, how do you get that number? Well, I got the number, Tommy, because when I calculated everything, if I get a house, right, from one of my investment properties and stuff like that, I'm going to pay like an average, maybe like $1,300 to $1,500. So let's take out my calculator, guys. You guys know how I feel about my calculator. I like math because it proves people wrong and it proves that numbers are right all the time. So let's say, for example, he's paying $1,500 of rent a month, right? So that's around $18,000 a year in mortgage payments, right? Which is not bad. It's actually very good. And say, for example, he wants to travel. He wants to buy clothes. So let's say, for example, he's spending another $5,000 on just like, you know, like miscellaneous stuff, like things that he doesn't really need to do, right? So that's another $5,000 a year. And let's say, for example, he has bills to pay, like internet bills and a whole bunch of other bills, right? So that's, for example, like on average, like light, water, cable, and all those things, they add up to around $600 a month. Let's just say that. That's a very high estimate, but let's just say that, right? So when we add the $1,916 that he's going to spend a month just from like rent and vacationing and buying stuff that he doesn't need, let's add the other $600 for his necessities. And when we do that and we times it by 12 a year, it's really just $30,000. So that other like $40,000, he doesn't really need. But the entire point is, being financially free is a completely different subject than how much money is enough money for you to stop working. And this is where I think the misconception comes in with people that don't have money, that don't have any plans on making more money, that don't have any plans on saving their money. They always put all their hopes on, out of nowhere, just receiving a big lump sum of money, and that way they're gonna fix their entire problem. Now, to battle one of the main issues that I have found, the long time question or statement that rich people are greedy and they never have enough money and they're just like awful evil people and money is the root of all evil, I'm here to tell you that that is complete bull crap. Why do I say this? Why do I say this is bull crap? Like, for example, when I was broke and I was making $60 wow, every time I say this I laugh, you know, when I was broke and I was making $60 a week, I was the exact same person that I am now, except that a lot of the features that I had back then, they kind of like pull through a lot. Because back then with $60, I didn't really have the confidence to do a lot of things I wanted to do. But now I am doing it, you know? And I wasn't a bad person then. Guess what? I'm not a bad person now. Money had nothing to do with that. It's just the type of person I am. If you're a bad person and you're broke, imagine what type of person you're going to be if you have money. You know what I mean? It has nothing to do with anything. And the entire thing that people say that, for example, you know, how much money is enough money? That's too much money. Blah, blah, blah. Listen, man. My financial freedom number is around 70, maybe $80,000 that I need to get, just like be 100% sure that I'm financially free. I never have to depend on anything, right? That's my number that I've came up with, right? But But that doesn't mean that just because I'm making $70,000 a year, I'm not gonna work any other job. You know, because for example, I'm gonna live like an average, right? I'm just putting up an average. I can die tomorrow, I can die today, nobody knows. But on average in America, I'm probably gonna live until I'm 85, maybe 100, because my grandfather, he died at 101. 105, was it, right? 105. So do the math. I'm 21 now, right? So do plus 65 to be 86, right? That's 65 years. So if I get to financial freedom by the time I'm 30, what am I gonna do for the remaining 40 to 50 years of my life? You know, and that's what I think with rich people. You know, they get to this point where they know they're financially free. They never have to depend on anybody. Don't have to depend on the government. Don't have to depend on anything. But they still keep making money because that's what they love to do. Warren Buffett loves his job. He loves doing what he does. Steve Jobs loved his job before, you know, before he passed away. You know, Bill Gates loves his job. The Facebook CEO, the guy that was like 17 when he created like Facebook and is like a billionaire now, like he loves his job. Like you have to love your job so you can continue doing that. And I think the problem is that poor people think about this fixed amount of money, and then rich people just think about their goal and just making sure they're safe along the way. So have like that safety net of passive income coming in so they can keep achieving their goals and moving on throughout life. You know what I mean? So while you're stuck in that job for the next 65 years that you hate and you're not doing anything to get out of, that person is in a job for the next 65, 80 years that they really love doing, and they have a lot of money. They don't have to worry about anything, but they get happiness from doing that activity. Never assume that rich people are unhappy. Like I read this in a book once. It said, you know, I've been poor and I've been unhappy, and I've been rich and I've been unhappy. And I can tell you that nine out of nine times I prefer being like sad and rich than poor and sad. You know what I mean? Like it just sucks. So guys, if you're And this is why I say, right? Entrepreneurship is not for everybody. You don't have to be trying to make like this entire billion-dollar business. You don't have to do any of that stuff. But you have to get to this entire mindset in your head that you have to shoot for financial freedom. Because if you never shoot for financial freedom, you're always going to be financially unstable. And it's nothing worse than that. Like, for example, if you have kids, if you plan on having kids, how do you feel waking up every single morning, going to the job that you hate, and putting that example to your kids? Like that example of, it doesn't matter, Billy. Like, just go to this job, go to school, do things that you don't care about, just get this money and then just pay all the bills. And then by the time I die, maybe the insurance is gonna pay you something. You know what I mean? Like, it's not a good technique. It's not a good tactic. Like, I 10 times prefer to say this, like, hey, Billy, like, why do I name my kids Billy? Hey, Billy, I worked this job. I love doing it. People told me not to do it. I did it anyways. I took the risk. I worked hard. I bust my ass. And guess what I did? I also built up passive income along the way. Because every time I failed at this job, I kept going. But I want to make sure that my family is safe. So if I stop working today, we're good. We're fine. We have nothing to worry about. And I want to put that same mentality into my kids. I don't want to raise kids. I don't want to raise anybody. I don't want to raise friends or anything that I decide to do. I don't want to tell people that money is evil, that like having enough money is enough. Like, who cares? You know what I mean? Just shoot for financial freedom. Guys, my name is Tommy Bryson. If you don't know me, you're gonna know me. And if you liked or enjoyed anything about this video, let me know in the comments down below. And let me know if any of the things I said today, for example, that money is evil, that too much money is bad for you, that like a lot of rich people are sad people. Like, listen, man, there are bad people in every single string of life. There are terrible rich people. There are amazing poor people. And listen, man, if you see someone that is rich and is fat, unhealthy, obesity, diabetes, heart attacks, everything like that, you can tell that that person only focused on one single aspect of life, which was making money. And if you want to critique that person, then do it better. Focus on making money. Focus on your health, focus on your wealth, focus on your love life, focus on your family, focus on every single aspect. And that's how you become a true winner. Guys, I'll see you next time. Peace.
You've got to start at the bottom.